Good day. This is Chapter 9 of Purposive Communication, which is nature and process of listening. So listening is very important when it comes to communication, because for you to be able to become a good speaker, you must become a good listener first. Okay, listening and communication. At the end of the communication line is an indispensable element, the listener. The active participation of whom either makes or unmakes communication. It spells a big difference in the communication process. At this point, it must be understood that effective communication, in part, came through a constant awareness and study of how listeners respond. So it's very important to know if the listener understands the message. Kasi pag hindi po, wala pong good communication na nangyari. Okay, best kind of listening characteristics is, okay, voluntary. Okay, these are listening characteristics. Voluntary or good listening begins with a willingness to participate completely in a communicative situation. So dito po, ito po yung mga tao or yung persons na willing na makinig sa iyo, sa mga sinasabi mo. So this is voluntary, no? Hindi sila napipilitan. Talagang gusto nila yung pakinggan ka. Okay, gusto nila pakinggan ka. Yun po. Next is purposeful. Okay, you choose to listen because of some very good reasons. Okay, meron kang gustong mag-get na information. That's why you are listening. For example, in a classroom discussion, the teacher is discussing about the lesson and the students are listening purposefully. Why? Kasi gusto nila na malaman or they want to understand what is the lesson all about. Para meron po silang mas sagot when it comes to assessment or meron ng exam or quiz na ibibigay sa teacher. Okay, so nakikinig sila ng mabuti. Okay, another one is motivated. Okay, motivated, when you have good reasons for listening, you are all keyed up for the activity and nothing can stop you. Motivated ka na makinig kasi motivated ka na magkaroon ng good grades. That's why you are listening very attentively. Okay? Doon sa sinasabi ng kausap mo. Motivated ka. Okay? Na kahit ano pa ang ingay na nakapaligid sa iyo, makikinig at makikinig ka. Nakatuon lang doon sa kausap mo yung attention mo. Okay. Cooperative listening. Okay. You keep quiet and give your wholeheartedly cooperation when you listen, because you hope for nothing but only the best from the speaker. So cooperatively, as you let the speaker talk and talk and talk, and you just listen. At binibigay mo yung attention mo sa kanya, hinahayaan mo siya na magsalita. Siya lang nang siya ang magsasalita. Ikaw, nakikinig ka lang. And ina-absorb mo lang nang ina-absorb yung ideas na sinishare niya. Next is critical listening. Okay? You follow the speaker's ideas carefully and get things clear so that in the end, you may be able to make intellectual judgments when you evaluate his ideas before responding. Okay? So, nagno-note ka. Okay? Kumuha ka ng key points na gusto mong i-ask sa kanya, na i-make clear niya. Okay? Na para kini-criticize mo siya dun sa mga sinasabi. Ganun po ang critical listening. You are criticizing the things na sinasabi ng speaker. Okay. Inaabangan mo siya magkamali. Yan. Pwede po yan, no? You are criticizing. Okay? Those are the characteristic po or listening characteristics. Now, we have here the types of listening. So, discriminative listening, it is the most basic type of listening whereby the difference between different sounds is identified. Okay? So, dito po, kahit na mayroong ingay sa paligid mo, nadidistinguish mo yung gusto mong pakinggan. Next is comprehension listening. It is comprehend. It is to comprehend the meaning requires first having a lexicon of words at your fingertips and also rules of grammar and syntax by which we can understand what others are saying. So, meron pong understanding na nangyayari when it comes to comprehension listening. So, critical listening, just like critical characteristics earlier, no? It is listening in order to evaluate and judge, forming opinion about what is being said. Okay, you are taking notes po dun sa mga things na sinabi nung speaker. Okay, and ina-evaluate mo at gina-judge mo yung sinasabi niya. Pinapakinggan mo kung tama ba yung sinasabi niyang information. Okay? Biased listening, it happens when the person hears only what they want to hear, typically misinterpreting what the other person says based on the stereotypes and other biases that they have. Okay? So, biased listening po, pinapakinggan mo lang yung gusto mong pakinggan at nami-misinterpret mo madalas yung sinasabi ng iba kasi meron ka ng opinion about that thing, that certain thing. Okay, meron ka ng opinion din. And ayaw mo nang pakinggan yung sinasabi ng iba kasi ang gusto mo lang is yung pinaniniwalaan mo lang. So that is biased listening. Next is evaluative listening or critical listening as well. We make judgments about what the other person is saying. So same po sila nung critical listening. Okay? Appreciative listening, we seek certain informations which will appreciate, for example, that which help meet our needs and goals. Okay? We just want to appreciate something. That's why we are listening. Okay, so those are the types of listening. Now, let's proceed with the barriers of good listening and how to overcome them. So, effective communication is a valuable skill in the workplace. And listening properly is the most important part of effective communication. So poor listening skills definitely make a huge negative impact on team morale and productivity. For example, sa isang workplace, okay? This situation usually results in conflicts and misunderstanding among team members and it increases a negative environment. So when you are not listening carefully, opo, dun sa opinion ng employees or ng employer, magkakaroon po ng misunderstanding. Hindi po magiging productive ang isang workplace kasi hindi po sila nagkakaintindihan. So what are those, no? So we have prejudice. Okay? It is a preconceived opinion of feeling, which is usually irrational. Overcoming this is respect the other person for his or her knowledge and skills. Okay, dapat i-respect po natin sila, wag po natin silang i-judge. Okay, make conscientious effort to take charge of your thoughts and consciously avoid taking on. I know what he or she is going to say. Okay? Huwag mong i-judge sila. Huwag mo silang pangunahan. Okay? Especially pag magsasalita. Okay? Distractions. Okay, we have four main types of distractions which is physical, mental, auditory, and visual. Pag physical po, for example, sa mga sign languages or non-verbal communication, dyan po yung pasok. Mental destructions naman po, pag hindi ka mentally prepared dun sa kausap mo, limited lang yung ideas na meron ka, hindi mo siya masabayan, pwedeng ganun po. Or siya ang hindi makasabay sa'yo, pwedeng ganun po. And pwede naman po na distracted ka kasi wala ka dun. Or meron kang iniisip mentally na iba. Okay, distracted ka. Hindi nakatoo ng attention mo. Yun po. Next is auditory. For example, yung noises outside, maingay, hindi mo naiintindihan yung sinasabi niya. Okay? So, pwede po yung distractions. And visual. Okay. Here's how to avoid these common barriers. Face the person who is speaking. Okay? Usap kayo face to face para magkaintindihan kayo. Kasi mas maganda na kausap mo siya. Minsan kasi, for example, sa chat, diba? Pwedeng iba yung way ng pagkakaintindi niya. Okay? Dun sa message mo. That's why, pag magkausap kayo magkaharap, makikita mo yung facial expression na. Malalaman mo na, ah, yun pala talaga yung pinopoint niya. Okay? Maintain eye contact while other person is speaking. Sabi nila, pag tinitigan mo daw ang isang tao sa mata nila, malalaman mo if nagsisinungaling sila. Okay? It makes sense, no? Kasi pag parang malikot ang mata, ay, nagdadahilan siya. Pwedeng gano'n. So, maintain eye contact para alam mo talagang, ay, yun talaga ang sinasabi niya. Okay? Ensure that you are comfortable and switch off your cellphone. For example, may kausap ka and then nagsiselfone ka, ganyan-ganyan ka. Cellphone ka dyan. So, syempre, yung isa or yung kausap mo, nade-distract ka sa usapan niyo. So, siya naman, nade-distract naman siya sa ginagawa mo kasi hindi ka nakikinig sa kanya or hindi nakatuon sa kanya yung iyong attention. Okay? Next, expecting others to share your personal beliefs and values. Everyone has their own personal beliefs and value system. So, you cannot expect them or do not force them na paniwalaan yung pinaniniwalaan mo. Kasi they have their own eh. So, you cannot please other people, no? You cannot ask them na, you cannot force them to believe what you are believing, no? Kung ano yung opinion mo. Don't force them, okay? Dun sa opinion or sa values or sa mga pinaniniwalaan. Okay? Don't expect others, no? You let them. Kung pareho kayo, maganda. Kung magkaiba kayo, you respect. Okay? The person. Kung anong pinaniwalaan. Para hindi magkaroon ng miscommunication. Okay? Or ng hindi pagkakasunduan. Eto na. Misunderstanding. Okay? The inability to hear correctly and is one of the many reasons for misunderstanding what the speaker is trying to communicate. You may think that it is impolite to ask the speaker to clarify his words or intentions, but that's not the case at all. Most people will appreciate the fact that you are making a focused effort to really understand what they are trying to say. Okay? Minsan nahihiya tayo magtanong kahit na hindi natin naintindihan, hahayaan na lang natin. Pero dapat po, pag ganun, mas maganda na i-clarify natin kung ano ba talaga ang ibig sabihin. Kasi mas maganda po na malinaw sa'yo kesa yung hinayaan mo lang na malabo or na hindi mo naintindihan. Ay, sige, okay lang yun. Ayoko na magtanong, nahihiya ko. Okay lang naman po magtanong, no? Especially to clarify yung mga bagay na hindi mo naintindihan. Next is interrupting. Interrupting a conversation with improper body language or inappropriate words will have a negative impact in effective communication. So dito po, pag na-interrupt mo yung kausap, okay, possible po na magkaroon ng miscommunication. Okay? So dapat po, pag mayroon nagsasalita, huwag natin silang i-interrupt. Hayaan po natin sila na matapos And then after that, you can share your ideas naman. Diba? Bibigyan naman din nila kayo ng time, okay? Para i-share yung ideas na meron kayo. So that is for chapter 9. Let's continue the discussion for chapter 10 next meeting. I hope you understand something and goodbye.
For more ICCT College's video updates, please subscribe and click the notification button.